up, y'all? It's the Machina, and it's time for another one. So, today's going to be a special day. And it's, I guess you could say I'm a little late because it was actually yesterday. But we're going to give a big shout out to Hayden Christensen, a.k.a. Anakin Skywalker, a.k.a. The Chosen One. Yesterday was his birthday, which was the 19th, and the reason I wanted to do this is because, not necessarily just because of, you know, Hayden needs to get a little more respect, you understand? And I think with all of the Disney side of Star Wars, there's this thing that people tend to forget that, well, at least I wouldn't say they forget, but they try to ignore the fact that Anakin was the Chosen One. And basically there's that. Because you can't have a Chosen Two. You understand? It doesn't make any sense. You know, I mean, but anyway, let's get to the heart of the matter anyway. Because this all actually started up because I saw this tweet by the man himself, Mark Hamill. And he put a shout out to Hayden Christensen for no particular reason other than being amongst the coolest of Canadians, a father young enough to be my son, and the one and only one I know they call the Chosen One. Boom. I love that. I love those subtle jabs to the Palpatine trilogy, because that's exactly what it was. The Disney trilogy that we shall not be calling a sequel to anything that was George Lucas's Star Wars. And, you know, just a sidebar, I think I've pretty said this pretty much most of the time on my channel, that I didn't have a problem with the prequels. I enjoyed Hayden's portrayal of Anakin. Yes, the dialogue was clunky, but that wasn't on him. That was on the person who had the dialogue out there. And I'm not knocking George either, because, you know, bad dialogue aside, again, it told the story of the rise of Palpatine and the fall of Anakin Skywalker. That's what the prequels was about, bottom line. And they told that story to the T, and that's basically it. But one more little tidbit I want to throw in there too, because, and this is an older one, but it made me think about where a lot of this you know, hubbub comes from. And of course, this is from my man John Boyega, who's just been killing it lately. I mean, I don't understand, like, because at one point it was almost like he was, you know, against people saying anything negative about Star Wars, but now it's almost like every other week he's with the jabs. So it's like him and Mark Hamill is just doing, like, almost like the Tony Stark, not even Tony Stark. Tony versus Cap versus Cap and Winter Soldier. In Civil War, when they was kind of just throwing a shield at each other, just boom, bang, bing, bang, bang. That's basically like how I'm feeling, how like John Boyega and Mark Hamill was basically just tag teaming the Disney trilogy at this point. Even though this is a little bit older, but it still plays into the point of respecting Anakin Skywalker. And this tweet for him says, "Sorry guys, but Anakin is slapping all of us in the pit of lava, including Kylo." And this is in response to the comic book resources article that says Rise of Skywalker prequel proves that Rey's a better Jedi than Anakin or Luke, which I just want y'all to take a step back and just see what they said. The Rise of Skywalker prequel, which means it's DLC again, proves this. If it's not in the movie, it ain't canon to me. And by the way, these movies aren't canon to me anyway, because they just blow. Now, if you want to go by books that are canon, the EU is there for you, because that is the only viable source of a story that we have that continues the actual Skywalker legacy. But because they just, I can't even say, look, and nothing against Daisy, I said this before, it's nothing against her, it's just her character is bland, and the story that surrounded her, what they tried to make her be, was bland, and that's how we got a bland character, and a bland story, and a bland trilogy. It not only just bland, but the trilogy itself was just completely disjointed. Thanks, Rian Johnson, if you want to have some thanks. But anyway, once again, big shout outs to Hayden Christensen. I know it was your special day yesterday, but hope you had a drink. Drinks on me from there, from, you know, a virtual drink. How do you guys feel about the subtle jabs, once again, for Mark Hamill? Letting people know to respect his dad. Well, his movie dad. Respect that movie dad. You understand? Let me know how you feel about that. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit that notification bell so you can get on the topic. Remember, can't be good. I heard that the best bet is monopoly. Ain't no space, control death.